Let Studio One crash is a really easy thing to do. In this video, I have two tips for you to decrease the chance of Studio One crashing on you.
Consider subscribing if you already haven't and hit the bell button so you don't miss anything.
Hey guys, how are you doing? I hope you are doing marvelously well. In this video, I'm going to talk about Studio One. Studio One is crashing a lot, at least with me it is. And I tried to contact Presonus, but yeah, their support is not the best. I like the software in so many ways, but their support is really just bad. They flat out deny that there is a problem, and still after iteration after iteration of the software, it still keeps crashing. I noticed in the over the last year or so, I tried to experiment with some things, and there are two things that stood out that improved the stability of Studio One. The first response of Presonus saying that my DAW is crashing, as they say, it's the fault of the plugins. And I don't agree with him, simply because a piece of software that is external, if you have programmed your software right, and I'm a programmer myself, I know what I'm talking about. If you program your software right, it doesn't crash when an external factor of like a plugin doesn't function properly. They have a really bad, I repeat, really bad audio unit support. Those audio units is the standard. They support two types of plugins, that are the VST plugins and the audio unit plugins. Those audio unit plugins are used by Final Cut, for example, and Logic, for example. And the first time that Logic has to crash on me, that has yet to happen. So it isn't the fault of the plugins, it's something that they programmed or that is not right in the right way supported. It's something on their half of the end. So they need to fix that. And I switch it off and I start using the VST plugins. And the problems with crashing decreased a lot. I will show you now how I disable those audio units.
When we open Studio One, go to Preferences. Then go to the last tab. This is the first, the second, the third, and the fifth, Advanced. And then on the last tab again, Services, and click away the scary message. Then find Audio Unit Support and disable that. Studio One asks to reboot the software and of course say yes.
You have to bear in mind that if you disable the audio unit plugins and you have older projects that you use those audio unit plugins in, that you need to first finish those projects, because if you disable that and you open those old projects, Studio One can't find your plugins anymore. The second thing that I discovered is recently I had some problems with my audience sound card, and I switched back to the internal sound card of my Mac, and two things happened. My latency decreased, so my sound card is faster, and my Studio One is crashing less. So again, I don't agree with them that it is my fault, because it's an external thing. You need to take into account that isn't functioning properly and program your failsafes on that. But regretfully, they don't do that. That's the way Presonus is. They make a lot of hardware, but supporting external, no, that's not something they want to do. So change sound cards. It really sounds stupid. I connected my monitors via the mini jack connection, and it works better. I hope these tips were useful to you. If they were, please leave a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you already haven't, and hit the bell button to stay updated. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.